Alright guys, what is up? Welcome back to The Drive Home. I just got out of seeing Winnie the Pooh, Blood and Honey, Part 2. I didn't see the first one because of how absolute horrendous reviews it got. But, sure buddy, come on. But, I jokingly saw that this got an 100% on Rotten Tomatoes, and it was part of my, like, unlimited movies thing, so I figured I'd check it out. Well, the movie... Oh, there's not much light there. The movie was not bad. It was pretty much what you would want from, like, a campy horror movie. I don't really know the budget of it, but it looked significantly better than the original. I'll say that. Plot is pretty much exactly what you would imagine. Although, okay, I guess I'll start from the beginning. They played off the first one. They kind of did a Thanksgiving. If you've seen that, you're my best friend, and you don't need to subscribe or like the video at all, because we're homies. Thanksgiving did the first movie, and then the second movie was called Thanksgiving 3 because they just completely said their movie was too bad for a second movie. Hilarious. But so what Winnie the Pooh did, or I guess it's not Winnie the Pooh, it's just called Blood and Honey. What Blood and Honey did was... Hang on. A little bit of rain on the road and people don't drive anywhere close to the speed limit. So what this one did was they played off the entire first movie as a campy, shitty movie in the Blood and Honey universe. Like, the people in the second movie were watching the first movie as, like, a shitty horror movie you would go see in, like, the 80s type deal. So I thought that was pretty funny. It pretty much is just the same dude, Christopher Robin, trying to figure out what happened to his brother who got kidnapped as a kid. There's a couple other, you know, they've got friends and shit in there, but as you know, in these horror movies, the majority of the people just die. So unless it's the main character and the love interest, usually they don't survive. So there's not really any point talking about them. Spoiler alert. Turn off the video now if you care. Spoiler alert, I'm giving you a couple seconds. The whole plot was his brother got kidnapped as a kid by some guy who needed his gambling debt paid. And then all these kids got abducted and were given to this freak scientist who was doing animal experiments. And that explains all the genetic modification freakazoid animals. Like, and all of his cronies. Speaking of cronies, more spoilers, but you should have been gone by now if you cared. Piglet, brains blasted out immediately. Like, first 10 minutes, it was awesome. Just guts and gore everywhere. I will say about this movie, it does not look cheap or cheesy. Like, whoever did the practical effects, I think they said them at the end of the movie, but I was already walking out at that point. Amazing job. Actually, fantastic job on the monsters and the, kills, the prosthetics. The first scene was just this girl getting burned almost alive. Her face had just melted, so she couldn't even see. Oh my gosh, it looked really good. Back to the plot. I gotta beeline this or I'm gonna keep getting sidetracked. So this guy did experiments, and that's where you get Pooh. Piglet, who gets his brains blasted out. Owl, I think Owl's a new character for this one. And then Tigger, which, fantastic line. The cops, the way they introduce Tigger is the cops find Pooh's hideout in the big tree, and all the cops look at each other and say, "Let's bounce." And that's when you hear a voice in the background go, "That's my line," and then kills them all. It's awesome. pretty cut and dry plot that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It's, you know, what you would expect. Would, so it's a Fandango movie. Tonight was the last night. So if I could say, should you spend money on it? No. You should not spend the $15 movie ticket on it. It's not an exceptionally long movie. You need about 0% brain capacity to watch it. Great kills. I'm sure Papa Meat or Meat Canyon is going to have a video on it soon. So I'm sure he'll tell you and have a much better video than I am. But it's honestly a pretty good watch. If you're like, you know, you're coming down from work, you want to put some bullshit on before you fall asleep and go to bed, or, you know, you just want to have a laugh with some good scenes. It's honestly, it is not a bad movie. Is it an 100 on Rotten Tomatoes? I don't think so. But it's a good watch. And you know what? I think if you've got time to watch it, you should make that happen. All right, guys. Thanks for driving with me. See ya.